know about you and John Paul.
No, no, I know that's no excuse, but I know Steve wouldn't like it.
Are you cheating on me? With John Paul?
No. I was just offering him some legal advice, that's all.
You really think I'm thick enough to believe that, don't you? So come on. John Paul said I wouldn't like it. What wouldn't I like, James?
Me acting as his lawyer again. He knows how jealous you can be. What were you doing filming us anyway?
I wasn't filming you on purpose. We were checking out the new security cameras.
Look, I really like you, Steve. But this insecurity over John Paul has got to stop. You're making issues out of nothing, and frankly, it's exhausting.
Can you blame me for being jealous? John Paul is just always hanging around.
I promise you, there is nothing going on between me and John Paul. You need to start trusting me.
I've given you a chance to own up. If you can't tell me the truth, I guess I'll have to find it out for myself.
Right, £6.72 and I owe you.
Yeah, who leaves 2p in a tip jar?
That happens all the time, and they expect us to thank them for offloading the shrapnel on us.
Maybe that's why they left you an IOU.
No, it was probably Nana or T. They've always got the dirty mitts in here.
Game over. Loser.
You! You're me assassin!
Right, hand over your target. Wanna see who's next on my hit list.
Right, job done. Loads of letters from the kids at school. Sally's gonna be a blubbering mess when she reads that.
Oi. What were you and James talking about at mine yesterday? I saw you on the CCTV.
I was asking if it's all right for me to travel on a suspended sentence. I just fancy getting away for a bit, you know.
Isn't that a question for your probation officer?
Yeah, probably. I shouldn't have bothered James with it. I'm sure he's got more important things to do.
Hey, so do you reckon them letters are enough to convince Sally to go back to her job?
I just hope she knows how missed she is.
Hey. You are not going to know what to do with yourself when all this is finished. Going to have to go and get you an hobby. With a stranger, I barely know. Swearing this will be the last, but it probably won't. I got nothing left to lose or use. Or do my bad habits need to wait? I stare in space. Oh!
Be back! Oh! Ow!
Oi, are you okay?
Oh, you should have been assigned for the wet floor. Time off work now, probably several rounds of physio.
You don't have a job.
Oh, don't waste your time. He's broke. There's a coffee shop in town that pays full compo, just FYI.
Oh, Turtle!
I'll tell you what, you are something else.
What the?
You're supposed to be Richard Gere.
Younger and slightly less good looking.
Ah, oh, Pretty Woman. Yeah, that was my favourite film as a kid.
Oh, that makes sense.
I know that I can be blunt sometimes. This is me stepping out of my comfort zone to show you that even though we come from different worlds, we can still find common ground. And what's not to like about Verdi?
Who's Verdi?
I am very fond of you, Steve.
I'm very fond of you too.
Aww.
I give it a week.
Your opinion is as relevant as you are. See you tonight.
You know, men only grovel like that when they've been playing away. It's called overcompensating.
Can you lend a tenner? I want to treat Perry to dinner.
Can I borrow £10? Can they teach you anything at that school? Oh, I've only got 20.
Call it inflation.
It's a good job I'm in a generous mood. Couldn't wait till after your shift to see me?
You're a liar and a cheat!
What?
I know something's going on between you and John Paul. So the big romantic shot was just to keep you sweet, wasn't it?
Where's this coming from?
That doesn't matter, does it? I'm right, Anna.
It was just a kiss. And we weren't even together when it happened.
So if that's all it was, then why lie about it?
Because you've been so paranoid and anxious lately after everything that happened with Leah.
Don't do that. Don't try and turn this around on me. Now, you think you can talk your way out of anything, don't you, eh? Using your fancy words and all your lawyer tactics.
Look, I didn't tell you because I didn't want it to get in the way of a good thing. We've been happy.
Are you sleeping with him?
No. It was a one-off. John Paul was in a vulnerable place. He made a pass at me.
So you're saying that you stopped it?
Not exactly. He couldn't go through with it. It was too soon after George. I'm just being honest. That's what you wanted, wasn't it? We'd broken up. You didn't want to be with me. I haven't done anything wrong.
You've lied to me over and over again, James. You even got John Paul to back up your story.
Well, we didn't want you to get hurt.
You know what? It's too late for that. If you would have just been honest with me from the start and then fessed up, then maybe we could have worked this out, but now...
No, it's fine. I just need you to ask the kids tomorrow to write some letters for Sally. Thanks, Nance. I owe you one.
I thought you were finished with all that.
I was, but I've got some free time, so I thought I'd do some more. If I can just show Sally how much the kids need her, then...
You've done enough. Chill, go outside, enjoy the sun.
If I wanted to go out, I would.
You're obsessing way too much about this.
Sally's life calling is to be a teacher. Okay, if she doesn't change her mind soon, then the board are going to find a replacement before the next school
term.
Once
she gets an idea in her head, there's no stopping her. Look, do you remember that time when she was dead set on getting a shaggy perm?
It took us weeks to talk her out of it.
Yeah.
I just feel so useless. I've just got to keep busy. Anything to stop me thinking about him. I know I need to move on. I'm just not... really sure how.
Your world's been turned on its head. You lost your boyfriend and then you went to prison for it. Maybe you should talk to someone. Like Merce did, a professional.
Teresa, I'm fine. I'm fine, I'm dealing with it. Okay, I just need to keep busy.
You're paranoid.
You're drunk! Stop hiding secrets from me!
So I reckon Steve and your brother are breaking up.
What makes you say that?
Oh, I heard them arguing this morning. They woke up the whole house. Apparently Steve thinks James is doing the date with John Paul.
James seemed fine when I saw him before.
Oh, maybe they sorted it out.
Oh, you couldn't stand to see us happy, could you?
I really couldn't care less.
I know all about you and James.
Yeah,
he saw me everything.
Steve, calm down. Right, pull up a pew, we'll talk it over, have some vino.
How much of that have you had? But look at you, just a drunken mess.
This is my boyfriend, the drunken mess, who's decided to call me a liar and that I can't be trusted anymore.
Shut up! You don't get to judge me, you racist little junkie. And there it is. Yeah, I admit I've made some mistakes in my life, but I tell you what, at least I'm trying to be a better person. What are you doing with yours? Apart from drinking yourself into a state.
Go and get some rest before you do something that we both end up regretting again.